Si Amapola sa 65 na Kabanata, Group 5. What is book review? A book review is a type of literary criticism when a book is only briefly discussed or evaluated according to its worth, content, and style. A book review can be an academic evaluation, an option piece, a summary review, or a primary source. Introduction. The book Si Amapola sa 65 na Kabanata was written by Filipino journalist Ricardo Lee, also known as Ricky Lee, that is also famous for his other books titled Para kay B, Kung Alam Nyo Lang, Kulang na Silya, at Bahay ni Marta. This is a fictional novel about character that has different personalities. The character can also change into a manananggal, the fabled Visera sucker of the Philippine myth and lore. It focuses on love, friendship, and the different views in life of Amapola and his loved ones in a time that we seek mysteries and wonders.
This book, Si Amapola sa Kabanata 65, is all about the life of Amapola. Amapola is an impersonator suffering from multiple personality disorder with two alter egos. When Amapola was young, Mother Angie already knew that she had multiple personality disorder because one is a grow-up with the macho man who had a girlfriend, Giselle, and sometimes Saldi was the grow-up in an English cupboard. Social life focuses only on his...
Amapola fell in love with his co-worker, the windowed waiter Homer, who was the Truman's father. Aside from this, he also came from a line of manananggas. One day, his grandmother, Lola Sepa, time-traveled from the past to inform him of the coming prophecy. Amapola, allegedly, is the great-grandson of Sepa, Andres Bonifacio's lover from his time. According to the prophecy, he is to lead the Itinakda, or the hero who is his younger sister Mira, and find the kasiguran to stop the evil that will befall in the country in the upcoming May 10th election. Amapola was separated with Mira when they were young. Due to a plane accident, Mira died with her husband and left a baby girl. Having no choice, Amapola took the place of Mira and became the Itinakda. Instead, he was trained by Lola Sepa together with Emil, a short man and a diehard Duranian, to help the Itinakda as a manananggal and the new Itinakda. He tried to accept his fate and help his countrymen. However, he is clouded with questions, confusions, and doubts in the kind of society and people that he has to save. Moreover, having altered who constantly fight inside him and the pain of being heartbroken from a man has made him lose interest in the mission. Considering these hindrances, Lola Sepa decided to kill his alters. Whether Amapola and Nanay Angie regret it because they already love Isaac and Zaldi as brothers and children, and whether Giselle, Isaac's girlfriend, is very angry to Lola Sepa, Amapola was saddened with the death of his alter. Their deaths have led him to abandon the mission because of disappointments over the decision of Amapola. Lola Sepa disappeared and came back in the past. However, the disappearance of Lola Sepa has only led to the emergence of a new villain. Antero, Patungkaba, a manananggal who eats people, as he searches for adopted mother Angie. Amapola discovers that Montero is just another of his alter ego with a stronger presence compared to Isaac and Zaldi. He puts Montero aside again and falls silent. As he did with Isaac and Zaldi, he campaigned to stop and eradicate all manananggals has increased. Trono, a presidential candidate who is also an anti-manananggal, has created a secret lab to capture and experiment the manananggals in order to find a way to defeat them. But Giselle returns, now fat and pregnant, fighting to avenge the loss of her boyfriend Isaac. Because of Giselle, Amapola was kidnapped by Trono's camp. Giselle killed Emil out of anger. Giselle realized she had done something wrong, so she rallies Amapola. Eventually, on May 30, they staged a protest to accept the manananggal, but they failed. with unexpected twists and turns of event. The story turns into a theatrical war between Manangas and humans. Amapola flew until his death.
This book entitled Si Amapola sa 60th Kabanata, well thought out and finally written, once you start reading it, you will fully immerse in reading experience. It has humor and creative writing style, but it also affords to tackle modern problems, which is make the book easily addictive and relatable to the readers. It also uses hilarious, often iconic mixing, appropriation of the believing languages, English, Spanish, Japanese, and Swahili speak. This book is all about Amapola, a simple impersonator which suffers multiple personality disorders. You can read it once you see it, however you want, but I assure you that the impact of the story is felt. The story can make you feel all kinds of emotion when you read it. It's appealing to anyone but could be pointed out to young people, especially teens, and people who are part of the LGBT, but they should be aware because some parts of the book holds explicit content. This book is highly entertaining and educative, and we highly suggest people into reading this book. Si Amapola brings a vivid portrait of its reluctant heroes on border combat with its present presence, public and private, politics and culture intersect. It tackles about LGBT community, history, politics, and many more topics can be interesting to readers. Just like we've started before, the book is finally written and addictive. The use of popular word speak and some other usage of language make it uninteresting to read. There are still some questions that needed to be answered by the book, and it's fine as it is. It's a highly recommended book for its enjoyable to read.
Thank you for listening and God bless.